Hello everyone, I'm Chris, and today I will introduce you in the safe operation function of breaking before restricted area, also known as BBRA, in KUKA.Sim. In this first part of this little series, we will have a look on how to set up a safe cell and the restricted areas, the safe tools, and activate BBRA. You will learn how you can select the safe tool in the program. Let's get started in KUKA.Sim. So in the last videos, we already had a look at the safety configuration that is already prepared here in the device tree of my robot. So we already did the whole tool setup and the monitoring spaces, and we now want to have a look on how does it react. So we still had your working space, and if I just reset the simulation and press play, normally the robot will move really slowly because it's kind of now in this working space. It has this reduced speed, and it will give me as an output also here the information safe robot override reduction active. Anyhow, the robot will move very, very slowly, and we want to analyze a little bit why this is happening and then test it with breaking before restricted area. So for this, I will first now deactivate this workspace just by resetting the simulation and say inactive. And with that, it disappeared. So if you now go to the program tab and then to the trace features, and here you can collect the data, you can select the robot you want to collect the data for first and then tick in the box and go to the trace settings. So I don't want to have the axis position right now. I want to have the TCP velocity, and I want also to show the trace diagram, and it's going to be here on the lower side where normally the output is. So you can switch between the tabs here. If you're looking for this trace diagram and it's hidden, you can find it there. Now I reset my simulation and press play again without the workspace. You will see it accelerates and then brakes and then continues with a minimal but constant speed, colliding or interfering with this protected space. And if we have a closer look, it's a very constant speed of about 13 millimeters per second. If I go to the second channel of my tracing, I can select this breaking before restricted area feature now. And if I zoom out, I will see that at the beginning, so here at the start, the BBRA is 100% of the override, and then it will drop as soon as I come close to with the spheres to the protected space. Go to 1% of breaking before restricted area as soon as I collide with the safety space. So, and then it stays constant. And if I have had a look, you know, the speed was about 13 millimeters per second. So it actually continues with this 1% of breaking before restricted area all time until at the end it goes out. It will accelerate again, and then actually again here you see the acceleration real quick, where the robot got speed because it was outside of this protected space, and then actually accelerate again. So you can see there is already an effect of my robot, but actually it doesn't stop. Normally if you use safe operation, you would expect a stop zero as soon as the robot penetrates into this protected space. But in this case, it just continues very, very slowly. Why is that? Because in the simulation, the robot has no information about the hardware of the brakes, and thus it cannot really simulate where it would stop. And here it will just continue with this 1% override. I want to show you actually the BBRA feature right now. So if we go back to the home tab, go here all the way down in the configuration to this braking before restricted area, and activate that by clicking the box and resetting the simulation and play it. If we just jump back to the program tab and have a look at the trace diagram and here fit the view to our traces, then we can see that even though the simulation is running, it had a good start as we saw it before. Then coming closer to this safety space, it breaks down, and then as soon as it actually should penetrate here, it gets slower and slower and slower and slower until there is only it almost touches it. You can see it really close here, but it's actually at 0 millimeters per second regarding this speed. Here you can see really the braking before restricted area being active. It also works kind of on the side of the robot, so we have our whole robotic cell, and you can see that the speed is really accurate. It's almost the same as on the real controller. So if I now go to my main program, if we now have a little first point here, point one, that we touch up, and the second PTP motion a little bit further away that we can also now touch up with a right click, and then reset the simulation and press play. If we now look closer to what's happening, the robot brakes way earlier, gets slower, and then comes to a full stop. So you can see here that the robot is, or the spheres of the robot are not touching protected space. And if we look at this point one, it's still actually in collision with the protected space. So we have to move it a little bit further away, like so. Okay, let's touch up this point and now reset and play. And let's have a look how the robot reacts. So we get closer to the protected space with the spheres, but before we collide, we go backwards. And the robot accelerates, goes to point two. And if we see that on the diagram, if we press pause for a second, we can see that there's a little acceleration here when we retract from this protected space. And then again, this acceleration going outwards. And then here is the normal speed at point number two. Okay, so if we go back to the 3D view, we might now have a look how it works if we push point number two to the right side next to the edges of my safety cell. And here I will just turn a little bit my tool so that I can come closer to fence here, which is also my limits of the safety cell. And if I touch up the point here, reset and play, we'll see the same system or the same behavior as before. We go closer to the protected space here, then we go away, and then when we come closer to the cell, let me just pause that real quick and fit the size, and then we can see that there is a big deacceleration before that point here. So it is already home position, and here we already see, okay, the robot is braking up to 4% of the override, and then it really accelerates back again when we go back to the home. And like that, you can really see there's an impact on the cycle time.
This is the beauty of the braking before restricted area feature. Now you can see the impact of your spaces in the simulation up front before running it in on the real robot. Again, make sure also test this whole safety configuration on the real robot before deploying everything.
Thank you for watching this video. If you would like to see more interesting videos about KUKA's simulation world, feel free to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. Looking forward to seeing you in the next video.
Industrial intelligence.